to just thank my grandchildren and my children for lining up. I see God doing something in my family, something great. I just like for my family members to just stand up so I can just get them some kind of honor to let them know that I love them. I appreciate them. Brittany, what you sit down for? You my family too, baby. And I just want to let you know that God is working. And even before I began to pray, my mother was praying. And my grandmother was praying. So I know they was praying for y'all to get where God wants y'all to be. The first thing I want us to understand is that God, when he deals with us, prayer is so powerful. But we have to understand, prayer is a spoken word. A lot of times people pray in silence. You're not praying, you think. God wants to hear you. That's why he say, what you speak out of your mouth will either give life or death. Are we speaking to God or are we just thinking things? Prayer. My sermon is plugging into the power of prayer. Plugging into the power of God through prayer. And I began to look up some things. And even while I was looking up some things on the different people in the Bible that was praying, man, there was some powerful people praying. And then there was some people that was praying in the Bible and things happened. I mean, they happened. And I was like, man, this thing, prayer, is so powerful. Prayer took me from addiction to alcohol. I was drinking about a quarter of liquor a day. And people didn't even know I was an alcoholic because I was a sociable alcoholic. I was drinking a half a pint all day long. I kept buying half a pint, just drinking myself to death. And I had the desire to stop, but I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know why I couldn't stop. It took prayer to reveal some things to me. Romans, I just want to read this one scripture. If I can get, Rashad, can I get you to read Romans 12 and 1?
Romans 12 and 1. I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service.
Thank you. Holy and acceptable to God. He asked us to give ourselves as living sacrifices. Well, I have been praying all my whole life. And I have been crying out to God my whole life. And when I joined this church, I learned about laying straight. And I was like, you know what? I was like, I never heard of that. But I listened to the woman of God was talking about how she lived in the church. That she had moved in the church and began to lay day and night prostrate. And some of the things she said, she touched on some of the things that I was dealing with. And I was like, let me try this. Because I remember my parents say, you know, you don't have to like what a person say. But listen, because you never know what you need or when you're going to need it. Mm. Be willing to listen. So I listened. I went home. And she said, make an altar. Find a place where you can't get to the altar. Make you an altar. So I went in my living room. And I was hungry because I was like, man, this church is different. I've never been in a church like this. I was looking at the kids, how anointed they were. I was looking at how much love the people had. And I was like, when you come to church, sometimes you're looking for, you're so used to hypocritical stuff. You're looking for hypocritical stuff in the church. And I'm like, where is these hypocritical people? I'm like, I know they're in the church. And God was like, you in a place. Because when God told me, he called me, I was like, God, I don't want to be like everybody else. I want to know you, the real you.
Yeah.
I don't want to be half-stepping. I want to know the truth. Because I believe your word when you said there are greater things we can do than Christ. And I want all those things. And whatever it takes to get there, I'm willing to go through. Well, I went home and began to lay prostrate. And I was like, I don't know what to pray. Because I was used to begging God for stuff that I needed in the natural. But one of the first prayers that Apostle gave me was, it had the scripture, Psalms 37 and 4, and it said, delight yourself in the Lord and he'll give you the desires of your heart. And when I was laying there, the Lord kept saying that to me. He was like, delight yourself in me, and I'll give you the desires in your heart. Now, I began to talk to God. I was like, Lord, what is that? What is delighting myself in you?
What does that mean?
And he was like, spend some time with me. Show me how much you love me. He's like, remember when you was a young man, and you was chasing them girls? And you was like, spending your whole day just trying to convince them of who you are, spending time with them, yielding to whatever they needed. He's like, if you could do that for them, show me how much you could do that for me. So I started out, because I always used to land on the floor. Not praying, not on my face, with my face down, eating dirt, eating carpet. And I was like, Lord, people walking all over this carpet. And I was like, so I laid down there, Lord, it was like, get something to cover yourself up. So I had this anointed blanket brought it in to God. And I got it and I put it over me. And I made it like a tent. And I threw it over my head. And I put my face down in it and locked myself down. And I felt something start moving over me. And I got scared because I was like, what is that? First I thought it was my wife standing over me, getting ready to do something to me. And the Holy Spirit said, don't move. But me, being human, being disobedient, I look. It's nothing there. So I was like, oh, that's just me. I lay back down and I feel the same thing again. God was like, that's not you. That's me. So I began to question God because I wanted to know what was this? He said, first of all, when you lay like that, because they say to be in the throne room, in God's presence, you can't even look upon his train. You know how a wig down, the train run out? That means if you land in his throne room, your face gonna be in the dirt.
Right.
So he was telling me, you representing being in the throne room now. He said, now you feel just a taste of my glory. And I was like, Lord. I was like, I like this. So those 5 minutes turned to 15 minutes. To an hour. Then I started praying 3 times a day for an hour. Then I started praying at lunchtime with a group of people. And it got to, I was praying 4 times a day. Not counting when I came to the church and came to the altar. And then I was talking to God. I caught myself talking to God all day long.
Amen.
And I was like, man. And Pastor had prophesied to me right when I started doing it. She didn't know I was doing that at the time. And she was like, you're going to start going in trances. Well, being an intercessor, she was passing these prayers out, trying to build us up. So I'm reading these prayers. And I'm looking like, man, I could never get through the prayers because I thought I was falling asleep. I was going into a trance. And I was like, but I would see different things, but I could never remember the whole thing I was seeing.
All right.
Me, I'm gonna talk to God. God, what is this? I was like, what's going on? He was like, I'm pouring in. And he said, I'm going to fill you up. I was like, yeah, whatever. So I kept on reading the prayers. And I was doing it every day. And I had a stack of prayers. It took about an hour to read them all. And I was fast reading them. I was speed reading them. Because I'm at work. And I'm like, shoot, I can't get caught in here reading this, and I'm supposed to be supervising people. I was like, I need to be getting through this real quick. So I would read them real fast. But they would penetrate when I read them, and I'd be in the middle of one, and next thing you know, I'd be like, and then I start seeing stuff, and I come back and I'd be like, wow. I was like, I know I'm not sleeping. I go back and read. It's like, what is God doing? I don't know. Papa told me, she's like, you gonna start going to trance. I didn't know, because I was new to this kind of spirituality. You know, I ain't know nothing about this prophetic thing and this power that's in this church.
Right.
Man, that stuff got to hit me. And I'm like, whoa! And God was like, you gave yourself. It's like, sometimes I have to scare you, take you to your lowest place in life, because you won't submit. You won't listen to your spirit. You keep worrying about what somebody else thinking. You keep worrying about who looking at you. You keep worrying, you let fear set in. And God said, now that you know if you leave here today and you ain't on the road to where I called you to go, you know where you're going. You ain't coming up here with me because you're on the wrong road. And I was like, oh, I don't want to go down there. I was like, I don't know too much about it. And God was like, let me remind you of something. He was like, when you was dying, he was like, it was like a blackness. It was a pitch blackness. Like being in a lonely black place. That's the worst feeling you can have. Imagine being locked up in a box about this big, and it's pitch black, no light nowhere, and living eternity in that. That is horrendous to the mind. And that's what he was showing me. I was like, ooh. I was like, I'd rather be burnt in fire than to be locked up in that kind of darkness. So I had to change my mindset. You know, we don't want to change our mindset because we like our flesh. But let me tell you something. When you go to war or do a covert activity for something, when they bring you back, they deprogram you to get your mind right. When you pray, God is deprogramming you from the natural, trying to get you into the supernatural. But because we don't have a strong prayer life, we can't get from the natural to the supernatural, because we keep slipping back. Of prayer, some of us don't understand how powerful prayer is. Prayer is so powerful. When we have prayer, it builds a strength.
Yes.
When Ezekiel testified, she was talking about how she prayed to God to give us some strength to make it through the night. Think about the strength that he gave her with the favor he gave her. So when you pray, this is no joke, this anybody can have this. When you begin to ask God and give yourself from here, not from here, when you tired of being tired, when you fed up with life, when you fed up with the ups and downs, when you fed up with the failures, the shortcomings, the struggles, that's when you begin to weigh things. Is it worth it? Every day, fighting against the same enemies. Every day, people coming against you. You getting upset. There's no reason for you to be upset. The power of prayer will give you joy no matter what comes against you. The power of prayer will illuminate you. It will empower you. You have an old cell phone and it began to take longer, it won't hold the charge as long.
So when you start using it, you be like, this phone, man.